I now present to you Virginia Senator Jeanne Marie Devolites Davis.
Thank you. You know, this is so frustrating for those that are members of the General Assembly because we've had no input and we have no decision-making power. No one has ever reached out to us and asked us, how do we feel about this? And we keep up with what's going on normally by going home and talking to my husband or reading the Washington Post, which I think is a shame. First, I want to tell you that Senator Jeanne and Howell had hoped to be here. She missed session yesterday. Of course, she's homesick. She's feeling very poorly, but she sends her regards and wants to let you know that she is working on this as well. Many of my colleagues from the legislature were not able to make it today, but I want you to know that we are communicating with the governor, we're sending letters, we're calling the office, we're letting him know that those of us that represent the top of the Dulles corridor represent the citizens that live along the corridor, and as representatives of the citizens, we want this to be underground, and we expect him to use every means within his power to make sure that that happens. Particularly important to me because I've lived in Vienna for 26 years. I raised my four daughters here who are now 18 to 28, so I've got that behind me. But I've watched the traffic in Tysons grow and grow and get markedly worse as I've raised my family to live here and commuted throughout the community. I will tell you that I am the chief patron of the Northern Virginia Regional Transportation Bill in the Senate. We are working very hard to pull this together so that we can provide hundreds of millions of additional dollars for transportation in Northern Virginia. That's so critical in this whole transportation debate, even as the Dulles Rail. What I did in my bill was I added tremendous revenues so that the state, through this transportation package, could supplant the dollars that the locality through the special tax district would have to pay. If we can get this through, then through our transportation plan, we can generate and pay for a good portion of this project, hoping that our little effort in that regard will help let the FTA know that the state is a partner and wants to provide as many of the dollars as possible to this project. So I have 2 weeks left in Richmond. I was told recently that I will probably be a conferee for the transportation package. I can't tell you how. I'm excited. It's a great opportunity that means no sleep for the next 2 weeks, but that's okay. But please know that all of us in the General Assembly who represent all of you are doing our best to communicate with the governor that this is very important to our citizens. But please also understand that we have never been asked our opinion about this. We have never had an opportunity to be involved in the discussion. All we can do is serve as your advocates and communicate to the governor and to our other elected officials who were involved how all of you feel. And one thing I know in representing Vienna is this community comes together when they want something and they don't take no for an answer. So thank you very much for your participation.